Do we witness to others the joy of the gospel? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God. Every day, amen.
Saint John the First was a 6th century pope and martyr. He was born in the Italian province of Tuscany and was elected pope and bishop of Rome in 523. The Mediterranean world was by this time divided into the Eastern and Western empires, each having a separate emperor. Christianity was also divided by the Arian heresy, which denied the divinity of Christ. King Theuderic, the German chieftain, who was in effect the Western emperor, was himself an Arian. Though he was initially tolerant of the Catholics in his kingdom. Soon after, John was elected pope. Justin, the Eastern Emperor, began repressing the Arians in the East. Theuderic was upset by this, and he forced John and other religious leaders from the West to visit Justin in Constantinople for the purpose of lessening the restrictions place upon the Arians. Because religious questions had political implications, it was not uncommon for kings to involve themselves in religion and for bishops to find themselves involved in politics. Little is known about the outcome of the negotiations Pope John conducted with Emperor Justin. But because the two leaders got along well together, a paranoid Theuderic assumed they were plotting against him. When John returned to Italy in 526, Theuderic had him arrested. Pope John died soon after he was imprisoned, perhaps a result of the treatment he received, thus earning a martyr's crown. John was the first of 23 popes of that name, and the first one to be canonized a saint. Sometimes religion is inescapably involved in politics. As Saint John knew, when this happens, our primary loyalty must be to Christ, not to the rulers of this world. Peter turned and saw, following them, the disciple whom Jesus loved, who had lain close to his breast at the supper and had said, "Lord, who is it that is going to betray you?" When Peter saw him, he said to Jesus, "Lord, what about this man?" Jesus said to him, "If it is my will that he remains until I come, what's that to you? Follow me." This saying spread abroad among the brethren that this disciple was not to die. Yet Jesus did not say to him that he was not to die, but, "If it is my will that he remains until I come, what is that to you?" This is the disciple who is bearing witness to these things, who has written these things, and we know that his testimony is true. But there are also many other things which Jesus did. Were every one of them to be written, I suppose the world itself could not contain the books that would be written. Why do we compare ourselves with others? And no wonder we have so many rivals. We want to be better off than our neighbor. While Peter and John were both called as disciples of Jesus, each was given a different task or function. When Peter questions John's role, Jesus retorts, What is that to you? Follow me. Peter's given task was to shepherd the sheep of Christ, and in the end, to die for Christ. John's role was preeminently to witness to Christ and to give his testimony to the gospel. John lived to long age and wrote the gospel as his testimony to the reality of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. John ends his gospel with an astonishing remark. Human books cannot exhaust the person and work of Jesus Christ. His power is inexhaustible. His grace is limitless. His wisdom unfathomable. His triumphs are innumerable. And his love is unquenchable. We can never say enough of the power, majesty, and glory which belongs to him alone. Do we witness to others the joy of the gospel? Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the power of your love, Lord Christ, fiery and sweet as honey, so absorb our hearts as to withdraw them from all that is under heaven. Grant that we may be ready to die for love of your love, as you died for the love of our love. Jesus, King of mercy, we trust in you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers, and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and couples for Christ.